Dear students, in this short video, I will try to explain the important accounting treatment on admission. When a partner is admitted into a partnership business, right? So when a new partner comes to the business, let us see here two partners, A and B. So these two partners are sharing in this ratio 2:1, and a new partner is coming to the business. So C is the new partner, so C will be getting a new share, and both A and B, because of C's admission, both A and B have to sacrifice some of their share in normal circumstances. And for that, the ratio has to be changed, or ratio will be automatically changed. So C will be getting a particular ratio. So based on that, we have to rework the existing ratio. So the old ratio will be changed to a new ratio in this case. Okay. So the old ratio becomes a new ratio. Or rather, old ratio changes into a new ratio. In the old ratio, there will be only the existing partners or old partners A and B. And in the new ratio, there will be C also coming. Okay. Right. So, as an example, like, let us say C, the new ratio is going to be 1:1:1. Everyone will be getting equal share, right? So we have the new ratio. This is the new ratio. We have old ratio. So using these two information, we can very easily calculate the sacrifice ratio. We can easily find out how much A and B will be sacrificing. In order to find out the sacrificing ratio, we have to deduct this new ratio from old ratio, or let us say old ratio minus new ratio will result into sacrificing ratio, right? So when we are doing a question, when we are solving a question, when we are solving a numerical question, we have to see the old ratio, we have to see the new ratio. In some cases, new ratio will not be given in the question, but there will be clues. You follow the clues and calculate the new ratio. Old ratio will be always there in the question. So when we calculate new ratio, then we can easily calculate the sacrifice ratio, because we already have the old ratio. We have calculated new ratio. So from these two information, we can easily calculate sacrificing ratio, right? So this sacrifice ratio is calculated in order to give compensation to the sacrificing partner because of the arrival or because of the admission of a new partner. So when a new partner comes, existing partner lose some of their share, so they have to be reasonably compensated. So for this purpose, C brings a compensation, brings some money, and we call it goodwill or premium for goodwill. So C brings premium for goodwill in cash in order to compensate the old partners who are sacrificing. Clear? So this is what we are doing in the change in the ratio. So this is what happens when there is admission of a new partner in a partnership business. The ratio will be changed. Profit sharing ratio will be changed from old ratio to new ratio. And the difference of this will be sacrificing ratio. So this is the first accounting treatment on admission. Okay. Now the second one. So why we are calculating sacrificing ratio? We calculate the sacrifice ratio in order to compensate to the old partners. Okay. So this compensation is known as actually goodwill. So what do? We calculate the total goodwill of the business. Then we find out how much is the new partner's share, and that much share should be brought by the new partner. So basically we are calculating this goodwill in order to compensate to the old partners. It's very simple. So for that purpose only we calculate sacrificing ratio also. So all these things are connected. The ratios, calculation of ratios and calculation of goodwill, treatment of goodwill, all are connected, dear students. So I repeat, the ratio is, sacrificing ratio is calculated in order to compensate the old partners. And in order to find out the compensation, we calculate goodwill. We take the share of goodwill of the new partner. Then he brings that required amount, which will be given to the sacrificing partners in the sacrificing ratio. So in this way, all the three, okay, the ratios, goodwill, compensation, these are all related. Now, when a new partner brings goodwill, there are actually three methods, right? First one is when the goodwill is paid privately. When the goodwill, or if the goodwill is paid privately by the new partner to the old partners, dear students, there will not be any journal entry. It will not be recorded in the books of accounts. Dear students, the remaining two methods of accounting treatment, that is premium method and adjustments through capital, we will see in another class, in the next video class, right? Okay, thank you very much.